Redheads aren't going extinct, they aren't soulless, well, any more than anyone else is, scientifically speaking, and they've been around for a long time. Hey, Gingers and others, Trace here from DNews to settle some old scores about those redheaded people among us. Now, before I dive in, you can probably tell I am not a redhead, although when I let my beard grow out, I do get little red hairs, so I don't know what that means. Anyway, redheads get a lot of flack, so we explored some of the science behind their freckles. Redheads have been in literature for a while. The Oxford English Dictionary says the term redhead first appeared in 1510, and it's associated with a fair complexion and auburn or ginger-colored hair. But the gene mutation that causes redheadedness has been around much longer. It came about 50,000 years ago when humans moved from Africa into the cloudier climes of Europe. The redheaded human is a result of a gene mutation on the MC1R gene, which is responsible for controlling melanin production, probably not a surprise. Melanin is what gives skin, eyes, and hair their color. Blondes are also a result of the change in the MC1R gene. New research published in the journal Molecular Biology and Evolution discovered another mutation that causes fairer skin complexion. Scientists discovered it while analyzing the DNA of 1,000 people from Spain and figure it's our body's response to lower vitamin D production from the lessened sun outside of Africa. Sadly, the mutation goes hand in hand with lessened protection from UV rays as well. Darker skin reflect the rays better than lighter, so fair skin has a higher risk for melanoma or skin cancer. When lab rats with comparable pigmentation were tested, 50% developed melanoma before they were even exposed to the UV light. So get out there and get tested, redheads. So while some of those sayings about redheads are true, rumors of redhead extinction grossly exaggerated. In 2005, the internet was abuzz with a source at the Oxford Hair Foundation claiming the recessive gene was disappearing. In reality, 80% of humanity carry the recessive gene underneath their own dominant one. It's important to note that the gene is double recessive, so both parents must carry it to birth their own little ginger snap. And in total, 2-6% of humans in the Northern Hemisphere and only 1-2% worldwide are gingers. This rare gene mutation has been rumored to affect other redhead traits as well. For example, pain reception. Even the Mythbusters explored this phenomenon. Anesthesiologists know that redheads do need more of the lidocaine anesthetic before surgery, about 20% more than dark-haired people, in fact. However, when it comes to opiate painkillers, they actually need less. This has to do with pain receptors being triggered differently in people with MC1R mutations. Did you have misconceptions about redheads before? Be honest, everybody. Share your thoughts with us on our Facebook page. And thanks for watching DNews today. We air twice daily, 7 days a week, so if you like what you're seeing, savetesttube.com/dnews is a favorite so you don't miss any. It's easy. Thanks again.